You can't make this ish up. Sipping on this green smoothie, trying to detox. Hopefully it's not too dark because the sun went away real quick, but let's get into this. Hey, it's A back on your screen with another one. Hope you're all well. This is a story time about the time that someone trying to make me their sugar baby. First and foremost, do I give off sugar baby vibes? I need to know because I don't think I do. And especially back when, I don't even know where to begin. What I will say is when this went down, I was fresh out of a relationship. I don't know if it's me or the Scorpio in me, but when I'm out of a relationship, I need time to decompress. So the frequency was not on no levels of trying to get to know somebody or giving off that type of vibe, that's for sure. So let's start from the beginning. So as you guys know, if you watch my Wine Fairy series, I used to be a wine fairy back in the day. And I did this job for a couple years. And before that, I was a hostess at several restaurants within the same company. On this fateful day, when this investor guy came in, at first I didn't recognize him. One thing you need to know about low vision is I can kind of recognize who you are if you're the setting I expect you to be in. For example, if I know you from work and I see you at the supermarket, my brain's not clicking to think your height, your walk, and your talk is who you are. So it might take me a couple seconds to be like, oh, that's so and so. So when he came in, I had a little bit of hesitation. He's like, did you forget me? Then I realized, oh, it's the investor dude from like 10 years ago. So I said, hey, how are you? It's been X amount of years. What's up? We kiki back and forth. He says, how's it going? What are you up to? And why are you still here? Then we start to talk about my life, just pretty much like, oh, you know, this is just the in-between. I'm grateful I have a job. It puts a roof over my head. The people are treating me well here, X, Y, and Z. Then he says, well, you know, I'm getting into this tech industry. And for those of you who don't know, I'm a huge tech head. You probably can't guess because how could I be into tech when I can't see well? But I love knowing about tech. So when he mentioned some things, I was like, let me get into them things. So he said to me, hey, I would definitely love to have you on board. I have connections if you don't work for one of my companies, at least one that I invest in. Here's my card. I thought, wow, that's so nice. It's too good to be true. Maybe it's the jaded part of me, but I was hesitant. I did what any other girl would do. I messaged a friend and said, hey, what do you think about this? She said, you know what? If he's an investor, you know him from the past, he's never made a pass, take him up on the opportunity. I said, but something about the energy was a little off. Girl, you're tripping. Message him, see where it goes. It's better than working here, you know? So I said, okay, bet. I messaged him, thanking him for extending himself and asking to meet. He asked me when I was free. I thought, whoa, you're the investor. You're the one who's super busy. Okay, though. So I gave him some options and then he chose Monday after work. I'm thinking, okay, I guess business people meet over meals. Nothing unexpected about that. Just to paint a picture for all of you guys, you're gonna try to say it was your aura, your vibe, it was what you're giving off. I wore a loose jumpsuit. It was culotte style. How do you say that word? Culotte? I don't know. It's a loose flowy pant jumpsuit. My hair was straight. I was giving professional, okay? We meet up. We're driving there. And at one point, he's like, oh, shoot. I'm thinking, did you forget something from one of your jobs? Are you missing something? You need to stop off somewhere? No. Does this guy not open up the middle compartment? Take out a wad of cash this thick. I forgot to deposit it. Okay, you couldn't have forgotten to deposit it in your mind. Why did you have to take that and show me? Wealthy people are weird. I don't know if that flex was supposed to do something, but it didn't. And he noticed it, so he switched the conversation to start talking about my interest. What do I do on my free time? What do I like reading? What do I X, Y, and Z? And the conversation was cool, it was fine, whatever, no weird vibes, but that part just stayed in the back of my mind. Why'd you do that? We get to the restaurant, and it ends up being full. And one of the people that approaches us happens to be my old manager who now owns this spot. Oh, funny seeing you two together. The investor guy says, we're here to talk business. They kiki for a bit. Then he says, okay, let's try the next restaurant across the street. We go across the street. And when we go in there, he knows the owner there too. As we're getting seated, he stops by two or three tables because I guess he knows everyone. Our investors all go out at the same time, out at the same spot. Once we sit down, he tells me, this person owns this, invests that, and that person does this. We sit down. I order a glass of wine. I forget what he orders. The first question he asks me, how open-minded are you? The little voice in my mind says, this is weird, but okay. I said, I don't know, pretty open-minded. He says, okay, because I have a lot of ideas for what industries you can get into. And he starts rapping about what tech and this chip and this new machine. And I said, oh, this is actually really cool. We talk about this for about 10 minutes and I'm really engaged because it seems like he's serious about all this tech stuff and the different industries he's dabbling in. Why does he switch it up real quick and ask me out front bluntly to be his escort? You can't make this a shot. He had to flip the script so quick. He says to me, I'm already disgusted, guys. You know, I've always admired you over the years. You've always been so intelligent and just beautiful and very minimal, but also intellectual. And you know, I think I have a proposition that would work best for you. I already know where this shit's going. Then he says, you know, I can get sex from anywhere at any time. And it's more than that for me. I want to be emotionally and mentally stimulated by the person I'm with. Would you be open to a arrangement?
Arrangement?
Blech. No, thank you. To paint a picture on his end, he's way older. He's also very fluffy. Not my type in any way. It's a no for me. So I said, no, thank you. Then he says, why not? I thought you were open-minded. Open-minded about jobs. Are you judging? No. There's plenty of girls that work with me that do that by night or have friends of friends who do that by day. I'm not judging them. How you get it, how you live, it's not my business, but it's not for me. He says, I don't know why you wouldn't be open-minded to it. You know, I'm sure I can pay double what your job is paying. You can save, you can travel until you get a job that you prefer. It's definitely a beneficial arrangement on both ends. No, I'd rather work for my money, and the whole reason of coming out tonight was to find a more mentally stimulating job. He said, well, it would still be mentally stimulating because I'd bring you around different circles. I could introduce you to different people, have different conversations. I could do more for you than a man your age could ever. If I wanted my life to be easy, this is a decision I would have made a decade ago. I'm not at the stage or phase in my life or my mind to, I don't want to entertain this. I'm just, no, not interested. He's like, okay, I don't know why you would say no. This is a great opportunity for you. I could tell you're so much better than where you are and what you're doing. And this could really help you reach the next pinnacle. You could save up. You could invest. You could start your own business. I could tell that you're savvy. Thank you, but no. One thing about me, and I'm sure you feel the same too, is a no is a no is a no. So the more you keep asking me, the more disgusted and disturbed I am with you. Because when I ask someone something and they say no, that's it. Grand opening, grand closing. Like, no is not the international no. So why is it that when I say no, people act like they don't understand English anymore? I don't get it. I just don't get it. After that point, I'm off of it. He went back to talking about the legit jobs that he had for me, but I was already turned off. So at the end of the dinner, I thank him, of course, and I realize that he has a screensaver. I said, oh, who's that? Because it's a little baby. Oh, it's my child. And he swipes to the next screensaver, and it's him and his wife and his child. And I think he could tell. He could sense that I'm just like, what the hell? So he begins talking about, oh, she knows about the arrangement. Women know when they get with men like me that the perks of having the nice car, not working, or being able to travel several times a year is that I get to live a life like this and entertain other women. So she's fine with the arrangement. And especially if we were to work something out, have a sex schedule and a contract. Come again? Sex schedule and contract? This is becoming more and more by the minute. Like, who says these things? And the thing is, he was straight-faced the entire time, which makes me realize this is probably something he's brought up to other women in the past. I said, again, no thank you. He said, at least, at the very least, sleep on it. You know, I hate to see someone like you that has so much potential struggle for no reason when I'm extending an offering. Even if you don't want to have sex, if you just want to hang out, I just want to be able to provide for you in a way that it doesn't seem that your job is. No, just no, just no, just no. I remember coming back home and feeling so dirty. Like, what did I do to have that happen? I texted that same friend who said, give it a try. And she said, you know what? I did had a tiny feeling, but I didn't want you to miss out on the opportunity. I'm sorry it turned out that way. Wait, you thought the same thing I did? You told me to go ahead? Yes. He and I never spoke after that moment. I think I've seen him once since. Gross. Again, for the third time, I have to make it clear, I'm not shaming anyone. Get it how you live it. If that's your lifestyle, I don't judge it. I actually have more respect now than I ever did before. If I felt the way I did from the proposition, I can't imagine what it's like to actually go through with it. You have to be a different type of woman. And I'm not saying that's a bad thing. I'm just saying it's not for me. I know for a fact, and ever since then, and even before then, I've had a lot of girl and guy friends tell me, girl, you should do it. You're already blind. Life is hard. Make it easier for yourself. Do it for a couple months. There's guys who don't even want sex. They just want the company or their look. Have you met me yet? Clearly not. I ain't down for that. I can't. Again, not judging anyone that can. Not judging anyone that does. Just saying it's not for me. Not saying I want to struggle either, but if it comes between struggling and being a sugar baby, I'd rather struggle. I'd rather hustle. So that's what it is. And that's my story. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, tap the like, subscribe for more story times. And until next time, stay safe, stay sane, stay blessed. Love and later.